One-year-old girl tragically losing her life.
And it's a bigger problem than we realise. There were over 2,500 dog attacks on people last year, and that's just in New South Wales alone. And for more information, we're joined by canine expert Steve Austin. Steve, a very good morning to you. Can you tell
us, Alice.
What causes some dogs to become dangerous and attack people?
A lot of it's got to do, Alison, with the way they're brought up as puppies. As you can see, we've got young Macca here at the moment. He's one of my young pups we're bringing up. And the most important thing you can do is make sure they get proper training at a very early age and lots of socialisation. Give them, take them everywhere with you so the dogs become very accustomed to all the noises, smells, trains, planes and everything around the cities that we live in.
Steve, I'm no expert in all this, but I would have to assume that a breed of a dog would be more dangerous than others, right?
Peter, I've been training dogs for over 30 years, and for every bad dog that bites or does something wrong, I can see the same breed doing something fantastic. I really believe there's not a bad breed as such, but there are some very dangerous people who own dogs who don't look after them and don't bring them up correctly. So if we can educate people to bring up the dogs correctly, I think 99% of our problems will be solved immediately.
So what should owners be doing to teach their dogs correctly so this doesn't happen?
Well, start them very young and get them into a very good qualified puppy class, which is extremely important. Socialise them, take them out at an early age, and look after their emotional needs as well. Get them to be happy, get them to be brave, get them to be able to cope with as many different noises and situations as possible. And also make sure that they've got boundaries. They are allowed to do certain things and not allowed to do certain other things, and train them in a very positive and kind manner. None of this dominating, none of this hard work or hardness on your dogs. Get a positive reinforce-based process. And if they do something wrong, basically don't reward them. If they do something right, reward them. Start at an early age and get them right from the very beginning, Alison.
Kind of like training kids.
Yeah, I mean, it's... It's hard to tell people what to do in a situation where a dog is coming after them because you can freeze. And my little brother was attacked by a dog when he was younger too up in far north Queensland. So, I mean, what is there any sort of main thing that someone can do if a dog is coming after them in a very, very threatening way that might reduce impact or reduce, yeah, a threat?
Well, very much so. And the most important thing is to go on a defensive mechanism. Get some items, a chair or a garbage bin or something, and use it as a defensive mechanism to block the dog away from you. If that's not available, do not attack the dog. Do not run, because if you run, that initiates a prey drive in the dog. Protecting your vital parts, I would advise people to turn around, protecting your face, chest and groin, and walk away from the situation as calmly and as quietly as you possibly can. But don't run and do not scream. That's very important.
It's hard to do that in the heat of the moment, though.
Look, it is. I mean, we've got a four-year-old Labrador at home and a 14-month-old son who's constantly crawling over it, pulling its ears. He's never shown any sign of aggression towards Mac. But is that something that we need to be vigilant about?
Yes, most definitely. It doesn't matter what breed of dog it is, Alison. Adult supervision is always critical, and children and dogs get on famously together and should always be on together. But like a pool gate, it should always be shut. When your child is with the puppy or with the dog, always have adult supervision. If you see the slightest problem, then of course you can step in. But while you're there, it's fine.
Steve, you got a demo for us?
Got a demo. I got my wife, Vicky. Don't worry about the dog, worry about the wife, as they say. Now she's going to send the dog on to me. I'm going to jacket myself up. Vicky's going to get in position. And what I'm going to do, Peter, I'm going to show you what not to do in a dog attack. Okay?
Right.
Okay.
So.
Beautiful looking German Shepherd. There's a German Shepherd.
Yeah.
What a beautiful looking dog.
Yes, well, like I say, don't worry about the dog, worry about the woman behind it.
He's ready. Look at him.
He's ready to go. Now, what I'm going to do, everybody, first of all, don't do this at home, right? This is really important. And I'm going to get the dog. The dog is going to attack me. We do this two or three times a week. We do courses for rangers, police, etc. And we explain to people what not to do in a dog attack. So the first thing I'm going to show everybody... Mm-hmm. Do not do this in a dog attack, all right? And then I'm going to do a calm position and you'll see the difference in the dog. You ready to go?
Right, let's go.
Here we go.
What not to do first?
So when you do this in a dog attack, it initiates the dog to bite more because he's trying to get away, right? If, however, you do this, turn around, relax, minimise your injuries.
Oh, look at that.
Do not look at the dog. Do not stare at the dog. The whole sort of situation diffuses.
Yeah, right. Wow. I'll tell you what, it's very hard to do that, though, in the heat of the moment. Yeah.
It is very difficult, but it's so important. And if you have a well-trained dog, you can do this. Sit. Stay. Do not touch me.
Now a treat.
Oh, yeah. Give that dog a treat for sure.
Well, if I say a magic word...
Yes?
Yes. Good boy. And it's all about being calm and as quiet as you possibly can. Leave.
Okay. Good to know.
Leave.
Okay.
Steve, that's fantastic. Yes. Thanks, Vicky Forrest, too, for joining us this morning.
Off he goes.
What not to do and what to do.
Yeah, well, that was quite compelling, that, Steve. Well done to you,
guys.
Mate. Yeah.
Glad he's okay.
Now he's got one of those meaty treats. What are they called?
Just a treat.
Okay.
Just a treat, Pete.
I tell you, it's a beautiful looking dog. I'm right into that. Oh. And there's the little fella. He's not going to cause any harm whatsoever. Is that a Cocker Spaniel?
That's an English Springer Spaniel, and he's a very famous one because his father was one of the dogs that went to Macquarie Island.
Oh, okay.
Oh, there we go.
So his name's Macca.
Now they're having a great time.
Go, Macca.
All right.
Oh, mate.
And as you can see, they're not nasty dogs. They're just very, very playful.
Yeah. Right. Okay, Steve, thank you very much. Now, if you're looking for a better deal on